Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Excel bootcamp course that you can find on my website at bringyourownlaptop.com. All right, it's the one everyone's been waiting for. It's pivot table time. Okay, what is a pivot table? It is a way to take longer data like this, okay, where there's lots going on, and break it down to usable chunks. Okay, I've created one. I just want to show you a bit of a demo. So on this other sheet down the bottom here, I've broken down that data to show me the products, okay, by the years, okay, and how much they were sold. I can break it down even further, and I want to say the products that were sold by just Daniel Scott, the salesperson, okay, or maybe Ben Samuels. Okay, so it's a way of taking this data and feeding it into a sheet and being able to kind of rejig it to prove a point, to extract data, to see it in a different way. Okay, so let's go off and build our pivot table. Okay, to create a pivot table, open up the exercise files. There's one there called pivot table data one. Open that up. Okay, and what we need to do is have our cursor anywhere inside this data set. Okay, you might have to select it if you've got lots of different groups of data you're working with. In my case, it's just one big chunk. So I'm going to have anywhere in here. I'm going to go to insert and this first one here called pivot table. Okay, and everything is fine. This one here, new worksheet, is just interesting. A worksheet, so we've got our workbook, which is the Excel file. Within this workbook, we can have worksheets. I've got sheet one down here, okay, and you can have multiple ones in here. They're just like pages in a document. So it's gonna create a new one of these. I'm gonna click OK. And you'll see down here, here's sheet one still with all my data, but I've got this new one, sheet two, which is gonna have my pivot table on it. Now, let's just name it. Let's double click sheet one and call this one maybe raw data. Okay, and sheet two is going to be my pivot table. Just so we know, can't spell, there we go. So what we need to do is we're gonna use this pivot fields here. Okay, so this is the most interesting or important thing when you're building a pivot table. And we're gonna use these fields down the bottom here. Now, the most important ones are rows and values. You'll use these the most. We'll use columns and a bit more and filters even less, but rows and values. So rows are this, okay? So the ups and downs, the y-axis, okay, the vertical. So I'm gonna put in, say, my products into here. So you click, hold, and drag them into rows. You can see here, it's listed them down there. And so we're cleaning up our data from that nice big raw data set and kind of, you know, just pulling the bits we want. So I want to know the products and I want to know how much was ordered, okay, the values. So you can see here now I've pulled from my raw data, okay, I've pulled out the products and how much was spent on them. Okay, so I can use a lot of these. So let's say I want to get rid of the products. Okay, so I can click on it and there's one that says remove field. Actually, I want to find out actually for my salespeople. There he is there. Okay, into rows. And I can see the rows down here, this is their totals that they've earned as salespeople. Okay, so I could bin that one as well and just kind of, I find rows and values often gives me the kind of most of the things that I want. Okay, and let's say looking at our customers as well. These are the customers and this is how much they've ordered. Okay, so that's rows, okay, down the side here, and values. Columns is kind of when you want to break out even further, okay? Say my question is I want to find out products and I want to know in which quarter of the year they were sold. Okay, so I'm going to bin this customer one, okay, and I'm gonna drag in my products, okay, and in the columns here, so that's products, but what I wanna do is I wanna add some columns along here, Q1, 2, 3, 4, so I can put in quarter, okay, and it breaks down my apples and when they were sold, okay, so where is it? Q1, okay, blueberries were sold, but there were no apples sold in Q1. Okay, it might be nicer for this one instead of products. I'm gonna remove this one and I'm gonna say salespeople. Okay, so there's their sales, okay, for Daniel Scott in this quarter and all the quarters plus their totals at the end. By far, Daniel Scott, okay, is the best salesperson on the planet. Good work, Dan. Okay, and poor Taylor, okay, doing badly. But that's all right. So that's a pivot table, okay, and there's a lot of like, when you're trying to work it out, you'll end up dragging like, is it meant to be this here or that there? Okay, does that look better? Okay, or sometimes you end up with the product along the top here, and I'm gonna get rid of this one, you're like, oh, that doesn't work. Kind of a, it's a strange looking pivot table. So you end up swapping these around. So don't worry. Often the values are the same. It's the price, it's the quantity, it's units sold. Okay, it's the numbers, it's the digits. Okay, and these columns and rows. Okay, rows mainly, and then columns to kind of break out a bit more detail. Now the last one here is filtering, and I find I use this not very often. Okay, I'm gonna show you two other ways of doing it. So it just means I can filter it even further, okay? Because I've got my X and Y axis done. So what I want to do is I want to break it down. Actually, I just want the results for apples, okay? I don't want all the rest of the data. So instead of filtering it, what I can do is, you can see here's his row labels, his little drop down here, okay? And I can say, actually, I untick select all, I just wanna show apples. Okay, and it kind of breaks down that content a little bit more. And apples were only sold in Q3, okay? Or I can go into here and say, actually, not apples, I wanna check on how boysenberries are going. Okay, and you can see boysenberries were sold in all four quarters, okay? And that's their grand total. It's a way of kind of like filtering down. So you can use these little kind of like filters. It doesn't matter if you're doing it up here. Okay, I'm gonna turn all these back on. And you can see that up here, I can say, I just wanna filter by Q1. Okay, because let's say Q1 and Q2, because Q3 and Q4 haven't finished yet, so we don't want to add those to our totals. Okay, so you can kind of do these filters that are within the labels here. Okay, so I'm gonna turn these all back on. So when's a good use to use these filters? It's when you wanna add an extra filter that's actually not displayed here, because we're filtering by our quarters and by our products. But let's say we wanna filter by the salesperson now, but we can't because it's not there. So this is where filters are useful. So in here, I'm gonna add salesperson. And you see along the top here, I've got this extra filter. It's in a weird place for me. I don't like it that it's at the top here, but hey ho. So drop down here and I'm gonna say, I wanna find what Daniel Scott's doing. Okay, so it's this kind of like third filtering. I've got my quarters and I've got my products, but I want to filter a little bit more, okay? And I want to break it down by salesperson. Now, I don't really like filters, just because there's a nicer way of working with this kind of the same function here. So I'm gonna drop this down and go to remove field, and we're gonna use something called a slice, okay, or slicer. So clicked in my table here, I'm at analyze, and there's this one here called insert slicer. So I'm gonna pick the exact same thing I had before, a salesperson, okay? And it gives me the exact same details, but in a cool little push button version rather than this ugly thing up the top that's insignificant, I feel. Anyway, so I can say, actually, I wanna go by Daniel, okay? I wanna figure out what Taylor's doing, and I wanna see what Ben's doing. It's the same thing, it's a filter, okay? They call it a slicer, and it's this cool little box out here. You can click multiple things. I wanna find Ben, so this little option here. I can want Ben and Daniel. Okay, so it gives me those options, and I can clear it out as well, clear this filter. Okay, to get rid of it, I can click on the edge, hit delete, and that's get rid of the slicer. You can have more than one slicer. You can pile them up next to each other so you can kind of make some cool combinations if you need to. So I wanna find out who earns the most as a client. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick my clients. Where are you clients? I can't even see the clients, customers, that'll do. And drag him into here, get rid of my products. Okay, and I want to find out their, actually, I'm just gonna get rid of this one as well. Okay, so this gives me all my clients and how much they've earned. Okay, and I can either just look through and see who the best client is, or I can use my more traditional sorting functions. So I can click in here and I can say, actually, I wanna sort it by the largest to the smallest. So, okay, these guys here, Fabricum, okay, have been the best client for me for that data set. Okay, but say I wanna break it out a bit further, I wanna know across the quarters who the best is. Okay, so I click on quarters and I'm gonna drag that into columns. Okay, so I can break it out a little bit. Okay, a couple of things to know when you're working with pivot tables is I don't like these little labels. They're cool for resorting things, but once you're done with them, they just kind of confuse the pivot table. Okay, so under analyze, and there's option in here that says field headers, and I turn those off. The graph still is perfect, except you don't have these like little things you can reorder by, and I think it just cleans up the table. So up to you whether you have those on and off. If you do lose this thing on the side here, okay, this pivot table fields list, okay, it's this option here, fields list, you can turn it on and off. Also, if you lose it, it's probably just because you've got your cursor clicked out here. Click over this, double check that's on. Okay, the other thing is, and probably the most important, and I like to save this to the end, is that if you update your raw data, weirdly, your pivot table doesn't update automatically. So if I go into here and I decide that actually this was wrong, okay, and I've put that to zero, I've copied that across, so lots of them are zero now, okay, even more to make it more obvious. And I hit save, and I go back to my pivot table, it's not updated. Okay, so what I need to do whenever I update my raw data, okay, I click in here, I go to analyze, and I go to this one that says refresh. Where is he? There he is there, refresh. Okay, and it will go and rejig it. Okay, so that's a pretty big one for the pivot table, a big marker right next to your desk. Okay, raw data does not update the pivot table. So that, my friends, is how pivot tables work. Okay, so I'm gonna set you a little exam. Okay, a little project. I would like you to create a pivot table that shows me who the best salesperson of Boysenberries were. Okay, so I want you to go through and create a quick little pivot table just to show me, you know, there's a couple of ways of doing it and how to display it. So I'd like you to display it and send me a little screenshot and stick it in the comments or links any which way, Dropbox, which way you can. I'd love to see it. All right, so that's it for pivot tables. Let's get on to the next tutorial video. Hey, did you enjoy it? If you did, please click subscribe or like, click the little alert bell as well. All of these things really help me as a business. Also, if you want the full course, check out the Excel Bootcamp on bringyourownlaptop.com. There's that course plus many others. All right, bye now.